Good evening, seniors and friends. Due to some technical reasons, we apologize for the late starting of the meeting. On behalf of Uttaranchal Orthopedic Association, I welcome you all. Let me introduce you our speaker and our panelists of today. We have with us Professor N.K. Magu, the hip preservation and pelvic stabilizer surgeon from Rohtak. After his retirement, he is now head of the pelvic stabilizer surgery at Max Smart Super Speciality Hospital, Saket, New Delhi. Welcome, sir.
Namaskar. Thank you very much, Dr. Ashok.
He will be presenting today Blade Plate, a versatile implant. We have with us our secretary of the Uttaranchal Orthopedic Association, Dr. Puneet. He is based at Haldwani. Welcome, Dr. Puneet. We have our panelists.
Thank you, sir.
Dr. Roop Bhushan Kalia from AIIMS Rishikesh. Welcome, sir.
Hi, sir.
Dr. Himanshu Kochar from Max Super Speciality Hospital at Dehradun. Welcome, Dr. Himanshu.
Thank you, sir. So kind of you, sir.
And we have Dr. Govind Sethi from United Kingdom. Thank you for joining with us, Dr. Govind Sethi.
Hi, everybody.
So, I would now request Dr. Magu to please share his screen.
Ye share screen kahan chali gayi?
Sir, it is a green button on the bottom.
Really, this has disappeared from my... It has disappeared from my...
Sir, once you touch the...
Zoom,
yeah.
It will be there, sir. Now I should
share the screen. Yes, and start your presentation, sir.
Is it okay now? Visible?
Yes, it is visible, sir. Just to increase the size, sir. That's good.
Okay, good evening, friends, and thank you, Dr. Ashok Sirohi. Ashok asked me, what is your introduction, sir? I said, no introduction. So, it's a great pleasure to talk to you. Every time someone asks me, you talk on hip preservation or pelvic fractures. So, Dr. Ashok was adamant I should talk on hip preservation. Dr. Shivashankar also wants to talk on hip preservation. I said I will talk something new, blade plate. It's also a good topic. And I hope you like it. I have tried to prepare it, and I say blade plate is a versatile implant. Why it is versatile? Because I should say, first of all, it preserves bone. DHS, DCS, the screw removes bone. So blade plate is a wonderful implant, and I call it versatile because it preserves bone. It's a fixed anchor device, not of two parts as with DCS and DHS. So it has increased strength, and it can be used for osteosynthesis or proximal femoral fractures. Maybe intertrochanteric fracture, maybe neglected fracture. Subtrochanteric fractures. And it can also be used for performing various osteotomies. So it is versatile. And same implant can be used again to make corrections or redo surgery if it has failed or there is some error in your technique. So the same implant can be used. The Enger blade plates are known since probably 1959 and were designed for proximal femoral fractures. Later on, Mueller realized that the people after osteotomy were given hip spica, and why not to use a double angle blade plate, and that is how it started. So I have my own now innovations, and these are special plates with special set of instruments. It has a U profile, which gives stability to this implant in rotation. If you want to create some extension of the proximal fragment or flexion, you can do it. This U profile has a beauty because this lodges the bone into its depth or its slot and gives stability. That is the beauty of this implant, which you do not get with a plate. But this requires three dimensions precision. Anterior posteriorly in the sagittal plane and in the coronal plane. Hence, this requires preoperative planning. But once you master this, then not much of planning is required. And that is what I will be talking to you also, if time permits me. The most important instrument is the chisel with a chisel guide. That's the flap or chisel guide, I should say. The slotted hammer. Now here is a slotted hammer. So in the sagittal plane, help with this guide, whether the plate is going anteriorly or posteriorly, it should be parallel to the shadow of the femur. So this is the chisel guide. This helps the placement of the plate in the sagittal plane. So this precision is very important for a learner. And to master it, one has to make the drawings. Sometimes people ask me, why not to do a osteotomy with the DCS or DHS? This removes bone. It cannot be used once you have done a DCS or DHS and it fails. You cannot reuse it to complete your procedure or revise the procedure. Whereas blade plate can be used because that is a bone preserving implant. And when blade plate fails once or twice in your hands, then DHS can be used. Hence both may be complementary. But of the two, I will say a blade plate is a better implant than a DHS or a DCS. So many imitations have come in the market, not good, very poor in quality, poor in designing and sizing. Cost speaks the quality. I was surprised, since I am doing a lot of osteotomy since decades, a person met me from a big town in Haryana and showed me so many implants. And the cost of the implant is 800 rupees. I'm sorry, I told him, if you are selling this blade plate with 800 rupees, how much you are saving and what is the quality of this metal? So we should be careful not to use imitations. At least we must be sure what quality of implant or metal is being used. These are fixed angle implants. Can be single angle or double angle. Children, adolescent, and infants, separate implants are there. Double angle in different, like 110, 120, 130 degree double angle osteotomy plates. Then contour plate, which was designed for distal femur, can also be used now for proximal femur. It's nearly a single or double angle, I should say. So this is a contour plate, different with various sizes. Up to 12 hole is the standard size, but local market is flooded with implants again of various sizes. But Mathis, who designed these implants, sent to me up to 22 hole plates. This is 130 degree blade plate. It is single angle. And you see, this is double angle. Maybe it is 100 degree double angle blade plate. So each implant has its utility. This is 95 degree. This is 130 degree. This is 90 or 100 degree. Maybe it is 100 degree actually. This is 120 degree. We call it double angle blade. Here you see here, this is one angle. This is second angle, double angle blade of three sizes, 110, 120 and 130. It is the beauty. I tell you why. Why 110, why 120, why 130? That will depend upon your planning. But a very simple thing I'll tell you, the usefulness of these angled plates. So this is 95 degree blade. The best for stable trochanteric fracture or stable intertrochanteric fracture, I should say, and best for subtrochanteric fracture as extramedullary implant and best for non-unions. This is double angle. It can be 110, 100 or 90 or even 80 degrees. And best for converting valgus into varus or performing osteotomies. And this part is called the elbow. This is the blade, this is the elbow, and that is the blade part. So where you are going to perform the osteotomy, it is this part. This part, arrow means this contains the bone in continuity of the trochanter or proximal femur. Very important tool. I have already briefed you. Slotted hammer from my department initially made slides at Rohtak. See how frequently I had been using and doing osteotomies. This is the chisel and the flap or the chisel guide. So when to use 110, 120, 130 or 90 degree? Very simple. If you want to create a higher angle, use a higher angle blade. If you want to create a lower angle, say you want to give varus correction, then use a lower angle blade. Mathematical simple. More proximal the displacement of the proximal fracture fragments, best is a higher angle blade. If displacement is too much, you cannot use a contour blade for performing osteotomy or fixation. More the varus, best is the higher angle blade. And worse is the contour blade. So certain things I have prepared for you. Now see, this angle is about 120 degree. There is a avascular necrosis here, and I want to bring it medially and downward, so I will perform a varus osteotomy. So for such a blade, higher angle to lower angle, so use a lower angle blade. Now here I have divided, put in grafts, and here I have set in my chisel, and you see that's the varus. So I have created a varus osteotomy with a lower angle blade. It is a 95 degree contour blade, which I have used here. And you find here, this is a girl from Kanpur. I have done osteotomy on both the sides. This side is also shows you AVN. So 95 degree contour blade, because double angle blade was not available to me. So I have used a contour blade, which is 95 degree, to create a varus of 20 degree. So low angle implant, when you want to convert a higher angle to lower angle. So 15 degree correction I have done in this patient. Again, there is a varus here. This case was given to me by one of my colleague at Max. So I removed this implant, and it is so simple, I tell you. There is so much of scar, nothing doing, no traction. Just insert the blade. I'm removing this implant and do an osteotomy. You see here, insert the blade and just valgize it. Confirm its position in both AP and lateral view. And beautifully osteotomy has been done to give you a proper nerve checked angle of about 130 degree, 35 degree. Limb length equalization is done and this patient is happy. Very simple thing. Why PFN and why other things? It is the versatility of this implant that you can use it for osteosynthesis of an unstable trochanteric fracture. of a neglected fracture and of a fracture where osteosynthesis has failed here, as you find here. See, simple osteotomy, simple blade. So 110, 120, 130 make it versatility again. This patient had undergone osteotomy 15 years back with 120 degree. So what I have done? So same track can be used here. I could not find more pictures because this laptop gets overloaded. So I have put a 130 degree blade plate. This is blade of 130 degree, excise other 10 degree wedge. So I converted 120 to 130 degree. Am I audible? Am I audible? Okay, thank you. So,
yes, sir.
See, the blade inserted in the same track and I excise a wedge of 10 degree here to make it 130 degree. So that is the versatility of this implant. You can use it for simple, you see, this is a basal fracture entry. So this is my setting. This is a supplementary angle of 60 degree. And you see here, I have stabilized a trochanteric fracture with a simple blade plate, no PFN or no DHS. For me, this U profile is excellent. If it is in the inferior quadrant of the head of the femur, this gives you the best of stability and easy to use once you are trained for it. That is the versatility. So 110 to 120, 120 to 130, you can convert, you can stabilize unstable fractures, you can do osteosynthesis of simple trochanteric fractures. And again, I'm telling you one beauty of this implant. You see, this is the image picture. So you, when you do PFN, you press it with some hormone bone lever with Steenman pin, and it may not succeed also. I did a case 5 days back, I did not succeed. So you do an osteotomy and pass the blade straight away into the neck. Now, as you bring the plate to the shaft of the femur, this deformity gets corrected. That is the beauty again. It is the versatility of this implant. The U profile, the U slot, or the blade plate gives it stability, and in one go you can correct this anterior displacement with a 120 degree implant. So not to struggle, just do an osteotomy and pass the plate and do the osteosynthesis. This is the best implant. Same again, I'm saying, this is a 15 years non-union in a 93 years male. No need to open the fracture site. No need to excise the fibrous tissue. No blood is required. Just insert the blade, making an angle of 30 degree with the shaft of the femur. Do an osteotomy at the intertrochanteric level, and result is yours. Angle is corrected. I have not excised the fibrous tissue. See, it's healing, beautiful healing. No blood is required. So that is the beauty of this implant. If you want to do other procedures, I think maybe others are better than me. I take very less time. I don't touch the fracture site. And I use this wonderful implant as an osteotomy implant and make the corrections, and healing is there. See, after 2 years, this is 2 years. So stability of U profile is excellent. This is the U profile which I have drawn it. It harbors the bone all along its track. What has happened, you see, in my hands, this blade has gone anteriorly. I saw after surgery that it is lying anteriorly and will cut through, or is partly cut through. See here, the arrow shows you. I removed the implant. You see, this is the implant removed. This is being removed. and just see. This is after removal of the implant. It is lying anteriorly, and here you see, I have just placed the chisel now posteriorly here, and implant has gone to the posterior quadrant. So I've done the correction, same implant. Just change the track. No bone is lost here because a little bit slot is formed. This doesn't matter. The bone is, most of the bone in the head of the femur is preserved. I just make a track here and you find it is stable and it has healed very well. It's healed very well. This U profile is so beautiful. Now, this was a cut through in my hands in 1991. This patient name is there. It healed. But you see what I want to show you. The blade is out, but it will not cut through. It has a very strong hold even in the neck, even in the superior cortex. I will show you other cases also. See? So I removed the implant because patient was having less flexion. There was impingement of the implant with the roof. So I removed it. So this is the track. And remember, this track remains track. It is hollow always. If at all you have to revise a procedure, you have to, depending upon the case and presentation, you may have to put a bone graft into it. My early days when I was doing planning, I don't know what year, maybe 90. Blade plate 95 degree is best for stable fractures intertrochanteric or this reverse Boyd and Griffin type 3 fracture, I should say, because this much of bone, 1, 2, 3, 4 screws are there, so this gives stable fixation. In this patient, you find again the implant is cut through. So I gave a thesis about, say, 2012, maybe Dr. Mittal, now he's a practicing surgeon. I reviewed all these patients. Even after 30 years, this implant is lying as such. It's because of the U profile. This did not allow for a complete cut through of this implant. This is iatrogenic in my hands. Because those days, image intensifier was not given to me. I was making drawings. At the times, I used to cut the capsule or not. Mostly based on my drawings, I was doing these osteotomies and blade plates as a blind procedures. All my students and my colleagues know it. For 10 years, at least, I have used
sir, your voice is not audible. Can you hear me, sir?
Okay, now am I audible? Am I audible, sir?
Yes, sir. Now you're audible. Yeah. Yes, sir. You are now audible.
Yes. I should share screen now again.
Yes, sir. You have to, sir. Yes.
Share the screen again, sir.
कौन सा था? यही तो था यार. न्यू शेयर आएगा. न्यू शेयर,
इट इज द सेम वन सर.
okay now?
Yes.
I think this is okay.
Yes, sir. Go to the slide which you are sharing.
So I was here. So see the range of motion, and even after 30 years, because of U profile, this blade is not cut through. So all these implants have templates given to us to know the size of the blade and the plate. But these days, digital access, you should be sure that you get the true film. This is the planning which we used to do earlier. The planning is a roadmap. It's the key to success. These are the templates for double angle blade plate. Now, I'll just give you a dynamic view of this drawing. We all know that macromolar osteotomy is a medial displacement osteotomy, intertrochanteric. So this is the osteotomy, and I displace this fragment medially. This is the point of entry. So if I use this elbow, which is 15 to 20 millimeter, and AH is the point of entry. So one is the implant cannot be approximated to the bone. And if you open it, or try to bring it towards the plate, this opens. Again, now if you use a bigger elbow, this is a bigger elbow, and put the plate towards the distal fragment, it again opens. So this becomes something like a blunt osteotomy, but this much elbow or implant with a 30 mm elbow is not available. So you cannot do it. So this is how the drawing helps you. Now you see here, this is the point of entry. This is the macromolar osteotomy, and this is the green is distal fragment displaced medially. So intertrochanteric medial displacement osteotomy. So as you insert the screws from 1 to 4, here, this is dragged towards the blade. So you cannot perform a macromolar osteotomy with a double angle blade plate of 120 degree. This is the teaching from this, or learning from this drawing. So it is the same illustration again, that this much elbow you use, and here it becomes a blunt osteotomy, and here it gets back to its original position. This is the elbow, this is the osteotomy, distal fragment displaced medially. Screws passed 1 to 4 direction, but macromolar osteotomy cannot be performed. And here you see, this is much larger elbow. That's the proximal site. So if you want to perform a macromolar osteotomy, you have to use a 90 degree blade plate. You find here, that is the elbow, and this will push it medially. Now you see here. So, macromolar also is a kind of a varus osteotomy. So you use a lower angle, and it is a medial displacement. So how to keep it displaced medially? This elbow, this part of the bone will keep it medially. So if you want to perform a macromolar osteotomy, you have to use a double angle 90 degree blade plate. This is again a counter blade plate. Two holes for 6.5 mm screws. Remaining are 4.5 mm cortical screws. This is the best implant for stable trochanteric fracture. for reverse trochanteric fracture, for subtrochanteric fractures, suprachondral type A fractures, fractures non-union subtrochanteric, I should say, or even for that matter, A type of suprachondylar fracture even. Unstable trochanteric fracture. In the year 1989, it is written here. Oh, connection gone again. Am I audible?
You are audible, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, audible, sir.
You find this is going in various. This is going in various. Am I audible? So, this is a cause for an unstable trochanteric fracture. You may use PFN. You may do any procedures. Whichever implant you are best, but not the contraplate plate. Now here is subtrochanteric fracture. And I use it.
You are not audible, sir.
Rotate with 180 degree. Insert it with blade facing the surgeon.
Sir, your connection is not stable.
Yeah, but I meant set up.
We could not get the last slide, sir.
Abhi, I will just show you how to get it. Yes, agree. Hearing it, but it's not getting.
It is coming, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Your connection is disturbing. So now you rotate it through 180 degree and put this blade into the track. Just
sir,
yeah.
You have to go in the previous one, sir. We lost it from the very beginning. From the X-ray.
I'm doing it. See this now?
Yes.
Subtrochanteric fracture extending higher. So two incisions, one above, one below. So this is the proximal incision. This is the distal incision. And you find the plate end. I have already made the drawing that a 14 hole plate is required to stabilize this fracture biologically with minimal invasive. I made the track, inserted the implant in reverse direction, now rotated through 180 degree and insert one screw distally in the reverse direction, and gradually there will be compression at the fracture site. You see, I have reversed it. Rotated it 280 degree, and that is the drawing of my planning. 1, 2, 3, 4 screws I have to insert, and you see this. This is paraplate. with minimum invasive technique, how plate has been used. And as I pass screws in proximal direction from distal, this is compressed. And you see here, just in 11 weeks, so much bone is formed. Just 11 weeks. So use of contour blade plate as a minimum invasive biological procedure, I'm just showing you. That's the proximal incision, that's the distal incision. And you can fix very long fractures. This is about, I'm sure this is 20. So I pass through here. Proximal incision and here, just healing in 10 to 12 weeks. The double fracture, one here, one in trauma in Zimmer group, being organized that time by Professor Tanna. It's a non-union of 15 or 16 durations, 16 years. And I tell you, contour blade plate is the best implant. Here is intractable non-union, I should say. 16 years old. So I distinguish the fragment about 6 centimeter shortening, and I stayed past the implant. Now, using a distractor or a tension device, you can use this implant as a reduction aid, and it is here. But this implant failed. Realize that the neglected fractures. One, you should put an interfrequent screw here. It's a fracture distal. There's no question on anything. It's a Mary United fracture where my arrow is there, and put some grafts. So again, so that is the point. It is healed. Neglected subtrochanteric fracture, and that is the fracture here. So I use a contour blade plate. I'm searching this patient now. He was walking before surgery, and now he can squat. So you can combine or tension the plate by so many ways. This is 9 years neglected non-union. And I tensioned this implant. See here. And it healed. See the result after 7. Work in a teaching institution where only poor patients come. They cannot afford 35, 40, 50,000, 6 rupees for your PFN and other costly implants. And it's very bad. And I really feel bad about it that these versatile implants have been withdrawn by the company because of financial reasons, economic reasons. And it's only in India. Japan people did not succumb to them. Japan people gave the synthesis a hell. Thus, these double angle blade plates cannot be abandoned, but they are abundant in India. They are available in Tanzania. I was there as a visiting professor. They are available there. Double angle blade plate, elbow I have shown you. This gives a uniform tension here. See here, compression. This I did a Venus astronomy. See this astronomy done, some medial displacement. Now implant is tensioned, and you see this implant is tensioned. So there's a uniform tension because of this blade, and there is a compression, which is uniform compression at the osteotomy site. But I tell you, if the bone is osteoporotic, sometimes then you should be careful giving this tension. Red arrow shows the osteotomy site, and the blade can migrate distally because of the tension. So you should be careful in osteoporotic fracture. You see this height is reduced, and height is further reduced. So you will have to redo a procedure with this. So in an osteoporotic fracture, for patients of neglected Perthes hip, when you do a varus osteotomy, you should be careful in giving attention to this implant. Now see this, it has gone higher up. The other good thing which I want to tell you, why I call it a versatile implant, that you can lengthen the neck and lengthen the limb at your wish. Again, that's why I say it is a versatile implant. You see here, find here. Osteoporotic, so there's a collapse. The blade has gone, so I revised it. I put other blade. Because of osteoporosis, the implant went in. Collapse is the rule. It is healed. So I use the same track, and see, it's a beautiful length gained. See, the neck is gained for this child who had 5 centimeter short me. If you take it laterally, put a wedge of bone here, the neck is relatively lengthened. Range of abduction is increased, and patient can sit cross leg. So that is again the beauty of this blade plate, double angle, I should say. Lengthening. You can achieve length at your will. I show you this. See, you see this. Congenital coxa vara. I do a lot of these cases. 5 cases I have done in Max itself, all referred to me. This case was also done in Max. She is baby Sarika. 2 days back she came to me at Rohtak for her follow-up. See this. This implant, locking plates, pediatric locking plates. I have lateralized it full. And you see here, how to show, because you are this coming. These pictures are coming. Is it visible to you, this? Dr. Sirohi, is it visible? So you see, neck is not completely lengthened with pediatric locking plate. If this is lateralized, actually this is medialized, this is subtrochanteric osteotomy, truthfully. See the normal neck, it is a short neck. But I use a blade plate. This other case, this is 14 years male. I again did it in Max. And you see, I have used a blade and intertrochanteric fracture, and neck is lengthened. Neck is lengthened. Neck is now lengthened from here to here. Not likely. If I keep blade more out, let it protrude outside, further lengthening can be done. So that is the beauty with this implant. Not likely to be achieved or done with the pediatric locking plates. This patient has undergone 4 or 5 surgeries. I call it a tota, or a parrot beak neck and head. See, trochanter is going up. Single surgery, I excise a wedge, and you see, this is what I achieved. This is what I have gained, just with the osteotomy. Neck length equalized, no limp. No limp now, 19 years follow-up, this is 10 years. Limb length equalized, can square toes as well as cross-leg position. See the body lever arm, muscular lever arm, rough estimate. Now again, other case I'm telling you, the versatility of this implant. Now, if it has failed, it is very difficult to use other TCS. But blade blade can be used. Other TCS will remove more of bone and may not provide stability. I don't know. My so many good friends are there listening to me, and they are more experienced than me. I respect all those people. But I never removed this fibrous tissue. I have just removed it and excised a wedge of 30 degree. This is CT scan. This is the implant being removed through a small incision. And I removing this implant and done this osteotomy. You find here, this is the osteotomy. And use the blade plate. This is the best implant for a failed osteosynthesis in a trochanteric fracture. It might have failed once, twice, or thrice. A blade plate will not fail. Even if it plays incorrectly, the U profile gives protection and gives stability. I have done this. See this. In 11 months, 6 years, she's the mother of a doctor in Hisar. The doctor is a radiologist. See, this lady is 100 years. This is after 9 years surgery. She is 100 years old now. The implant of my choice, I call it a wonderful implant, versatile implant. Gino Walton, you can use a condor blade plate. If you don't have double angle blade plate, do open wedge osteotomy. Correct valgus into normal. See this, I have done it. I have done this open osteotomy because this is valgus. And this is being used indirectly. The implant is used as a reduction aid. No screw is passed. And normalize it. I have normalized it. You see this? Very simple thing. We don't need any costly implants here. Or your so many implants now have come up, locking plates. Simple. Some places like Bhubaneswar, I am told the condor blade plate of Sindh is available. Or ask your vendor to have good metal and prepare it, like Surshat and all those people are having. Just cost not more than 3,000 rupees. And you see, it's healed. The Gino Viral valgus is corrected. See this, just with the simple blade plate, no double angle synthesis implant, which costs you now about possibly 30,000 or 28,000 rupees. A1 type of fractures, supracondylar, extra-articular. This is my drawing made those days. Must be, I think, 1990, 30 years back. I made special lecture for you people. The versatility of this implant, I have inserted straight away the blade into the track made in the condyles. This is step one. Step two, apply the make a track. Apply distractor. Put the blade. You see here? And apply the tension device. This is five step. And in six steps, it is tightened. And in the last, you put an interfrequency screw. No joke, it is truthful. Per operative picture, step by step, based on pre-operative planning, A1 type of supracondylar fracture, extra-articular, using a blade plate, 95 degree condylar made for it those days. Absolutely biological, did not look on the medial side. Because my drawing helped me how to go ahead step by step. But there are a lot of complications. This needs precision. It is not so simple. It can penetrate the joint. So remove it. Use a short length blade. or a contoured plate. This also collapsed. So you should be vigilant. Till date, obviously, in two of my cases, there has been DVT. Clinically manifested. Subclinical, I don't know, could be there. If it fails, it can be revised. Same implant, now it is revised. That is the versatility. There can be avascular necrosis if you do more of valgus. There can be loss of positions, so precision should be correct. Drawing should be made. You should be familiar with the instrumentation and the technique. And gradually, if you can learn THR, you can also learn blade plate. You can also learn fixation and do osteotomies. In one case, there was shutting of palsy. I don't know how it happened in my team. There was neuroplexia, the patient recovered. So tension the plate, I have told you. When the fracture is transverse, subtrochantic, or you do a varus osteotomy. So best implant to do the reconstruction of the proximal femoral fractures or subtrochantic fractures and performing osteotomies, special group of implants. Precision is required in sagittal and coronal plane, the fixed angle. Hence, this gives you better strength to the implant. If you want to create a higher angle, use a higher angle blade plate. If you want to create a lower angle, say convert valgus into varus, use a lower angle implant. More proximal the displacement of the distal fracture or distal fragment, better use a higher angle implant. And more the varus, best is the higher angle blade plate, and worst is the condor blade plate. Remember it. Stability is best given because of the fixed angle and the U profile. That is the excellent one. This case I have shown you, gone entirely, and this case I have also shown you. The implant is out, but it is in situ even after 30 years. Make a drawing, planning helps you. Even today, for difficult cases, I make drawings. You can use this implant to flex the proximal fragment in cases of avascular necrosis. You can extend the implant to bring a healthy bone under a weight-bearing dome by excising wedges. So is the versatility of these implants. And I have shown you, the longer the plates, you just give 2 incision, proximal, distal, minimal invasive, and you can have the best of results. Compression is uniform because of the blade part, not likely with the plate, because of the blade. So compression is uniform. Here you find the osteotomy is compressed or the subtrochanteric fracture is compressed. Cox Severa shortening can be corrected simultaneously, not likely with pediatric locking plates. That is the versatility of this implant. So this is a Cox Severa in, and this is a failed osteosynthesis again. The best implant because no bleeding except little bit at the time of osteotomy. Neglected fractures, I would say a blade plate 120 degree. Or 130 degree is the best implant. DHS is an implant for learners as far as osteotomy is concerned. It leaves a big hollow, hence makes revision troublesome. It was never designed to perform an osteotomy, but people are doing it. I welcome it. At least they are doing hip preservation procedures. Blade plate is a bone preserving implant, and it should be respected. The Indian Orthopedic Association should put in its efforts to tell the synthes, Johnson & Johnson these days, Johnson & Johnson DePuy, that it must provide us the double angle and counter blade plates of all natures, all types, as it is with Japan. And they should not consider us a weak people, but we are never concerned about the patients. That way, as far as finances are concerned, and the esteem of the country and the patient care is more important than anything else, or using so costly implants, 40,000, 50,000, 60,000. These implants are cheaper, versatile, wonderful, and the best for proximal femoral fractures, for subtrochanteric fractures, for a short bees, for non-unions, for neglected fractures, and all kind of avascular necrosis. Still best. If you want to revise it, these are the local limitations. Be careful. Lot of carbon and dust you see when you remove these implants. Lot of infection, these cases are coming to me, and these are being used by some of, I don't know name or mention. So imitations are not good, very poor in quality, should be thrown in dustbin. And this implant can be used as a reduction aid. Make your drawings, be skillful. Result will be yours. And this is how I make my presentation, and I thank you very much. I'm grateful to you. I hope I'm enough clear as far as the versatility of this implant is concerned. For me, it's a wonderful implant I have ever used for the conditions and indications. I have just submitted to all my friends. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Magu. I would request the panelists to clear their doubts also, and I will also be discussing some things. So Dr. Himanshu, Dr. Govind Sethi, Dr. Kalia, Dr. Puneet, anything that comes to your mind?
There are a few questions from the audience. Hello.
Go ahead.
Can we stop this chair?
Go ahead with the.
Oh,
with
this slide should be.
Sir, you can.
Stop sharing.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, Dr. Imran from Gorakhpur is asking how much this blade to be inserted from the subchondral bone, and what is the contraindication to this implant?
It should be 1 centimeter short of that.
From the subchondral bone.
Subchondral bone, and contraindications for various implants at various situations. The first contraindication is that you should be well versed with the technique. So many people ask me, sir, what should I do? I see osteotomy. Then they ask me, tell me the steps, sir. I tell them the steps. I request them, please do it if you know it, or don't do it. Don't spoil the case. Watch the interest of the patient. You should be very well versed. It's quite difficult, not that easy, to use this implant. I think that is very important. You should not use it unless you know it very well.
Sir, is there any standard textbook or any standard text which is describing the full technique of, like, regarding this, that how to do it? Because in most of the manuals which are coming up nowadays, they don't mention, for pediatric use, the blade plates are available. But from standard companies, the blade plate is not available for the adult use.
So
how to go about that?
You get the book of Shastkar.
Like you are repeatedly saying that you should know it well, and using this implant, I very well know, because I am from Rota, there is a learning curve for that. So, like, how can the learning curve be minimized? Where are the learning? Like, you are, I know that you are a mandir of this thing, but in all over India, where are people, youngsters can go and learn this thing, because it is not propagated by AO, so not many workshops are happening for this thing also. So how can we go about it?
Shastkar book is available, which tells you all the techniques in it. And now in Turek also, the 7th edition, I have given the technique And there's a book by Rastogi on hip, neck of femur possibly. The technique has been described in detail. So if you want to learn a short piece, then read literature and must read the book of Shatastra. It is available in the market, and I read this book hundreds of times, made drawings, and then you do it. It is not difficult because these days image is available.
And sir, which is the local company, which is the local company from which you can use the implant reliably? Kaushik, Sushrut,
Sushrut use, he has not been able to make it good one. But Green Surgicals, he has good implants.
Green Surgicals,
he has good implants. Synthes still is having. You people have to pursue. They don't create any problem for me. I get them easily. But you can use Sushrut, this Kaushik, or the green one. Green Surgicals.
Green Surgicals.
They have the instruments also, sir.
Yes, instruments they will give you any day. You purchase the instruments from Synthes, they will give you any day. Now this company is for having some sets with them and giving the surgeons who know it. I get generally set from them, instrument patient set. But it is very important that we should all impress upon the company, association should impress upon the company. I have written to Desai also to impress upon, because they are trustees, and I talked to possibly Dhillon also, that you've been very active in your group. I'm not that active now. Tell them to give us the implants. They can give it to Japan, why not to India? But local, you use local implants. You should use more and more of local plants. Doesn't matter, these local implants are also good by Green Surgicals and Sushrut. Nothing. You can also use DHS. That is easy for learners. Use DHS. You can still achieve your result. For a short means at least. I tell you, PFN is more of a drama. Whenever a case comes to me for discussion, I say it is failed. When its point of entry is so much disputed, how it can be good implant other than the principle of that it is intramedullary implant, nothing more than that. Sometimes they say it's a short nail, sometimes they say long nail should have been used, some point of entry is wrong. Then what is good with this, except that it's an intramedullary implant? Yeah.
But sir, like the usage of DHS has altogether gone down recently. Recently, there are many designs of PFN which is available. And like most of the people, I think the usage of DHS has drastically gone down. What is the opinion of the other faculties, because they are practicing in there, and intratrop fracture is the common fracture. How many of you people have used DHS, used PFN preferably, or DHS preferably? How do you take about it? Dr. Kalia is here, Dr. Govind is here, Dr. Siroi and Puneet, like.
Okay, DHS is the gold standard for stable trochanteric fractures. For unstable, it will fail. You may use PFN. But I do a stortmes. Or I fix it with a 120 degree blade. It has been a routine with me for more than 30 years. My other friends are there.
I like to say something. What I feel is that two screw PFN is not a good implant. And it has been withdrawn by Synthes. Surprisingly, the Indian companies are still manufacturing it because they are only copycat people, and we are still using it. And it has to be a single screw PFN. And there is no doubt about it that the screw business has given rise to more disasters than any good. The worst thing is doing a surgery without reduction. So if you are in varus, your fracture is not reduced, all implants will fail. If you have done your reduction, it's not in varus, most of your implants will work. So I personally feel it is the reduction which is the thing that we should be discussing rather than the implant.
Yes, I agree. Like, you have to reduce the fracture first and then you nail it. Like, it goes like that. It's fine.
It is always there. But I use DHS a lot and it gives me good results.
Sir, it is not the implant which is giving you the good result. It is your good reduction which is giving you good result. No implant can substitute for a bad quality reduction. So, I personally feel this discussion about implants is useless. The discussion should be how to get a better reduction. If you reduce it well, you fix it with anything which is stable, it's going to unite. It is destined to unite. Now, if you do something horribly on the table, it's going to stay. My personal thoughts are that intertrochanteric fracture is still not completely understood. It is pretty complex. It is not just one or two or three kinds. It is many kinds. And understanding the three-dimensional anatomy and the fracture is the first step in doing an effective treatment. So we will still have failures. Always we will have failures. But if we are good at reducing them, probably our failures will be very, very in number.
Not audible, Govind, you are not audible.
Am I not audible?
Now you know audible, now audible.
Yeah, I was doing a lot of blade plates before I came to this country, and I think what has happened with the blade plate, unfortunately, is when the blade was rampant, I came to this country around 95, and you were doing lots of blade plate at the time.
Yeah.
C-arm had just started entering. I remember when I used to do a blade plate, it used to be in the fracture table, using a cassette into a sterile cloth, taking an AP and lateral x-rays. And you should put 2.5 millimeter drill for anterior and posterior border of the blade to see the x-ray and then make a chisel. It has got a learning curve and it's a good implant, especially when you do osteotomies. And I think whenever our DHS used to fail, we used to use this blade plate. We only had 95 degrees, and we used to use the AO, you know, system in which we make the 90 degrees, 110, 120, and three sizes, up to 12 millimeters. So, whenever there was a failure, we told we like it. And some of the slides that we showed, in which there was a cut through the anterior cortex, it happened to me. But I never went back to remove it. I left it as it is, put down a bit of a post of rehab, and it was good. But I think what has unfortunately happened, the arm was not that available, more demanding, and that's why it went off quicker than rehab. But I don't think we can disregard the implant. Osteotomies, Bombelli used to use a lot, you know, and we all knew it from Bombay. We all used to go to Bombay to learn it. They're the people who were doing it to start with. And I had a fairly good success, but it's a more demanding implant. And I think when you do osteotomies or failed DHS, we always used to do it. This implant primarily came for subtrochanteric and supracondylar to start with. And then came the osteotomies, and then people started making different angle. But I think there is a good role for having this implant available. And I think it's worthwhile. So a lot of slides Dr. Magu showed, it came to me, my old, you know, memories have become fresh. Cut-throughs, DHS cut-throughs do badly as compared to cut-throughs of the blade plate, because you sight it at the lower aspect of the head, which has got a better cancellous growth of the bone. So yeah, I think, but your expertise and your, you know, you've done so much of it. In your hands, it's very good, but I think it can be easily done badly if you're not experienced.
A lot of people are doing, there are so many now papers on osteotomies using blade plate. And blade plate or shortening plates, they came also long back by Mueller, maybe in 70s. Not that the after counter blade plate, they all at the same time.
Sir, is anything available on the YouTube also?
Yeah, so many videos are there, and so many people.
Yes, there are videos.
On Facebook also. And I have conducted so many live demonstrations, even in Coimbatore with Rajasekharan. I gave two demonstrations on blade plate, how to use it as for osteosynthesis, and also as osteotomy after removal of the implant that failed in the metatarsal nail. And at so many places in Punjab, in Azamgarh, in Agra, I mean, all those people have started doing it. And I have conducted so many workshops, including the hip position workshop in Ramayya Hospital. And if you see, a large number of people from India have started doing it. And you can see my videos all available on YouTube. And each detail has been given in my videos. Not difficult to learn. If you desire, you can do it.
There's a definitely role for this implant. I'm sure this implant is going to stay, but I think it is a learning curve. And, you know, this is the problem. Because it's a fixed ankle, with DHSs, you put a slightly anterior, you take the, you know, the aspect of the plate bit posterior, and you will be able to fix it. But a blade plate needs, there is no second. You make a cut, it's there. If you put it into valgus, your problem is there. So you have to be very theoretical, very sound, and very good to learn it. And I think it's a good implant, no doubt.
Actually, it will become very easy when industry will start teaching. Industry is teaching on your locking plates of all nature. Industry is not teaching on these implants. We have also learned from the same industry when they were holding these workshops on bone models. Those days, they were not even sharing the videos. I told them, show us your videos. Now they have come up because we have started showing the videos to them. Of course, you for every procedure, you have a learning curve. You think EHR is easy? In every corner, in every gully, in every mohalla, the company people are reaching and they are luring our doctors, young doctors. They have forgotten the biological procedures. Even if fibula, you can do it. They are every, even you go in examination, I will do THR. And they are the targets. So many million THR this year, so many million TKR this year. I think we people, what kind of nationalist attitude we have? All our currency is going to them. They are just making fool of we people. What is the learning curve? But learning curve for THR is not that easy. You have to balance there also, muscle liver arm, body liver arm, top of the canter. Itne sare THR ke hai nahi sare cementless hi 15 kisam ke aadmi hai. Tum yaad hi nahi kar sakte. Blade plate to ek hi implant hai. In ladkon se poochho na. Ek minute batayenge sir isme ji. सोल्यूशन यूज करेंगे जी इसमें वैगनर यूज करेंगे पढ़ाया जाता है ना इंडस्ट्री ट्रेन कर रही है पैसे देती है इंडस्ट्री लेट अस बी ऑनेस्ट एट अवर हार्ट हम पैसे सारा स्वर्ग में लेके साथ जाएंगे हम
आई थिंक पीपल हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड देयर इज ऑलवेज अ टीएचआर आफ्टर इफ यू हैव डन ब्लेड प्लेट बट यू कांट डू अ ब्लेड प्लेट टीएचआर सो
नाउ यू हैव राइटली सेड
So you have to preserve the bone if you can. And I think in places like India, it has got a role. And I think we are getting caught to the Western system. It's a quick fix, but not a long fix. Believe me, THR, now you're doing it. You will have everybody, not failure. We aseptic loosening. You can't avoid that. That's going to happen in 10, 15 years. So if you can salvage and leave it for a one-off surgery, you know, we do hips replacement at 50 years. We know we're going to revise it 10 years. But in India, if you avoid surgery, the longer you do one replacement, you don't want revisions of replacements. May not be badly done surgery, but every surgery has its own limitation. You will have young adults avoid replacement if you can, as long as you can. But I think that in India, we should preserve the bone. You know, there is no turning back. You can't get the bone back.
In fact, it is said that the best osteosynthesis material is lying inside the hip. So rather than taking it out and throwing it into the dustbin, if you can definitely preserve it, there is no doubt about it. It should be done. But the problem is that we are living in a modern time, and some of the procedures like McMurray's osteotomy are probably now going into the history books.
Yeah.
And there is no doubt about it. There are a lot of implants which have gone into history books. And McLaughlin nameplate, Jewett nameplate, to name a few. Wainwright plates are must have also used all these. So it's okay to move ahead. It's always good to have a low-cost solution. But I personally feel that there are some situations in which a modern arthroplasty still has a very big role. Yes, it has to be prudently decided. And it is a choice that you should be making rather than pushing your numbers somewhere or trying to prove that you are a great arthroplasty surgeon. I think all our judgment should be tempered by a lot of wisdom, which is difficult to get, and save the hip whenever it is possible, and do an arthroplasty only if it looks like
it's required. Yes.
Very nice, Govind. I'm happy to hear your views and opinions.
Nice views, Dr. Kalia, and very good presentation by sir. I hope, sir, that the message has gone clear how to preserve and how to use.
Yeah.
Maybe if a few are inspired to learn it, it is worth it. Dr. Puneet, are there any more questions?
No, sir, there is not any other question. I think we should stop here.
So I would request Dr. Puneet to give a formal vote of thanks.
Thanks to Dr. Magu sir on behalf of Uttarakhand Orthopedic Association, Dr. Kalia sir, Dr. Govind sir, Devanshu sir, and Dr. Shiroi sir and Ortho TV team. Lots of thanks on behalf of our team. Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Good night. Thank you. So kind. Good night. Thank you.
Good night.
Thank you, Dr. Magu.
Thank you, Dr. Shiroi. Thank you, friends. Everybody. Thank you, Kalia. Yeah. Thank you, Govind, Puneet, and of course, Shirohi.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir. Good night, sir.
Thank you, Himanshu.
Yeah, thanks, sir. So kind, sir.
Dr. Ashok Shyam, are you there?
Grateful to Ashok Shyam.
I think it's not. Okay, so you please stop the live streaming so that we can chat for some time.
Yeah.
So you want to chat?
Thank you. Sir, it's a very nice one.